This poem is an older poem. And I stopped reading it for a bit, a few years ago, because I started getting a lot of feedback about it being harmful and how gendered it is, how that it might be damaging in how boxing the gendering is in a poem. And so I sat with that for a bit, trying to figure out what I thought about that and if I felt like it was a harmful piece. And I thought about changing the poem to change something. And then it all felt like shit. Felt really crappy, the idea of changing the poem. And it wasn't in line with my heart to change it. And I guess the gendering of the poem something I stand by. So I think they're important conversations, and I welcome them. Welcome them. Still there were days when there was no way, not even a chance, that I dare even a second glance at the reflection of my body in the mirror, and she knows why. Like, I know why she only cries when she feels like she's about to lose control. She knows how much control is worth. Knows what a woman can lose when her power to move is taken away. By a grip so thick with hate, you could clip the wings of God. Leave the next 8 generations of your blood shaking. And tonight, something inside me is breaking. My heart beating so deep beneath the sheets of her pain, I could give every tear she's crying a year, a name, and a face. I would forever erase from her mind if I could. But how much closer to free would any of us be? If even a few of us forgot what too many women in this world cannot, think of what the hell would you tell your daughter? Your someday daughter, when you'd have to hold her beautiful face to the beat-up face of this place that hasn't been the meaning of stop. What would you tell your daughter of the womb raped empty, the eyes swollen shut, the gut too frightened to hold food, the thousands upon thousands of bodies used and abused? It was 7 minutes of the worst kind of hell, 7. And she stopped believing in heaven. Distrust became her law, fear her Bible. The only chance of survival, don't trust anyone. Bolt the doors to your home, iron gate your windows, walk into the car alone, get the keys in the lock, please, 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 please open. Like already you can feel that firebreaker noose around your neck, 200 pounds of hatred engraved into the sacred soil of your flesh, please, 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 please open. Already you're choking on your breath, listening to the broken record of the defense. Answer the question, answer the question, answer the question, miss, why am I in trouble? Would you talk to your sister, your daughter, your mother like this? I, in generations of sisters, daughters, mothers, our bodies, battlefields, war grounds, beneath the weapons of your brother's hands. You know they found landmines in broken women's souls, black holes in the parts of their hearts that once sang symphonies of creation, bright as the light on infinity's halo. She says, I remember the way love used to glow on my skin before he made his way in. Every touch feels like a sin that could crucify Medusa. Kali, Oshun, Mary, bury me in a blue blanket to their gods. I know I'm a girl. Cut off my curls and want peace when I'm dead. Her friend knocks at the door. It's been 3 weeks, don't you think it's time you got into bed? No, the ceiling fan still feels like his breath. I think I need just a couple more days of rest. Please, bruises on her knees from praying to forget. She's heard stories of Vietnam vets who can still feel the tingling of their amputated limbs. She's wondering how many women are walking around this world from the tingling of their amputated wings, remembering what it was to fly, to sing tonight. She's not wondering what she would tell her daughter. She knows what she would tell her daughter. She'd ask her, what gods do you believe in? I will build you a temple of mirrors so you can see them. Pick the brightest star you've ever wished on. I will show you the light in you that made that wish come true. Tonight she's not asking you what you would tell your daughter. She's life deep in the hell of the slaughter. Has already died 1,000 deaths with every unsteady breath, 1,000 graves, and every pore of her flesh. And she knows this war's not over. Knows this bleeding to come. Knows she's far from the only woman or girl. Trust in this world no more than the hands trusted barbed wire. She was whole before that night. Believed in heaven before that night. And she's not the only one. She knows she won't be the only one. She's not asking what you're gonna tell your daughter. She's asking what you're gonna teach your son.